One of the common questions which patients ask me is, if we only have a single embryo on day 3 and it doesn't even seem to be a very good quality embryo, should we just go ahead and transfer it, or should we ask the doctor to grow it to day 5 and then do a blastocyst transfer? After all, isn't a bird in the hand worth two in the bush? Because if we put it back in the uterus, it may implant, who knows. But if it arrests in the lab, then there will be no transfer and there'll be no scope for any implantation. So we're guaranteeing that our chances of success are zero. And this is the justification a lot of IVF clinics also use in order to push back embryos on day 3. But the reality is that if that embryo is going to arrest in the lab, if it's a good lab, of course, it's going to arrest in the uterus as well, which means you've unnecessarily subjected yourself to a stressful 2-week waiting period full of false hope. Why would you want to do that? Isn't it better to know that the embryo arrested, so not only do you not have to wait for those terrible 2 weeks where every little twinge means maybe I'm pregnant, maybe I'm not, but also importantly, you lose that important information, because if the cycle fails, you'll never know why it failed. Whereas if you allow the embryo to arrest in vitro, you know that the problem was with the embryo, and therefore you can take corrective action in the next cycle. For example, you could find a better clinic which is better at doing blastocyst transfers, or you could consider using donor eggs. The whole point is you're losing valuable information by putting embryos back on day 3. So please don't allow your doctor to do this. It may be in his best interests, not yours.